Yeah.
The issue that I am given to talk, and I will be very brief, is about options for solving overlapping ancestral land claims. In essence, if you look at this statement, it's only one thing. Solve the overlapping. That is what is expected of me. Yes? I'm saying this because I was not called to solve all the issues but overlaps. It is true that this issue is very complicated. And it is not just imagination of people, it is a real issue. Historically speaking, people of this country, many of them, have been living at the same area. And they were sharing the same land. I can give you an example of Hereros and Damaros. They were staying together. They fought together. When the Germans came here, Damaros were fighting in the mountains of Kobabis against the Germans. The Hereros were coming from other sources. That's why the first people who left this country because the land was taken were Damaros, not the Hereros. Followed by other group which consisted of Hereros and Damaros. So they were sharing the same area. That is the overlap we are talking about. It's overlapping because we're sharing the same place. If you go today to Kobabis, that name is if you come to Windu, Windu is something that I don't know. We are talking about the Chomi there. I come. Both names for the same people. So they were sharing things. Now who is going to say this area is my ancestral land, is not yours? That is the overlapping that we are talking about. The other one we say, it's me, it's mine, because my grace, the grace of my ancestors are here. And on the other side, the other one say that mine also are there.
But he left.
What are you doing? But that is historical. It's not a fatal imagination.
Maybe my ancestors
are dead for you. How do you do that? How do you solve it?
Please, give us the possibility.
The mere fact that the area has been shared does not mean that it cannot be an ancestral land or things like you are sharing it. The way that they were sharing the land in harmony is the way that they will demand the land in harmony. And now that the land has gone, it does not mean that they want to go and return that land and take it by force from those who are now having it. That's not an issue. The fact is that restorative justice has been done in a different way. If, for example, the government buys a land to resettle people, you can give to the victims. A certain percentage is higher than those who didn't. And the mere fact that the people were staying together does not mean that they were resettled together. That means that says we have an ancestral land together, we must resettle together. It doesn't work. So this is what I'm saying. These overlaps.
It's confirmed. Overlapsing is confirmed.
But you have to understand.
No, there's no overlapsing.
You can never send an ambulance to go and pick somebody who is not sick. You can only take a person who is suffering, who is sick, to the hospital. Therefore, when you are talking about restoring, you cannot restore something which it did not exist. You can only restore something which was there, which was broken.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And when you are doing that, you are sharing something, you must first take, you must have a priority to settle the situation of those who are suffering.
Yeah.
But that does not mean that you have to discriminate against others.
Yeah.
No. If you do that, you are going too far. But you can say, for example, you are resettling people. You take 60 or 70% because you have got the first priority. The rest, leave it to other people. Don't be selfish. So that is the restoration. You are now in the country where we are moving in a different direction, a different unity. Even if it was yours, you can share with others. And I don't think that people may think that, you know, asking for ancestral land means that you have to go and resettle where the graves of your fathers or your mothers were. No! That land now is occupied by other people. What will happen is that when the land is now being bought by the government to settle, those people must have their priority. Not necessarily on that area, but wherever the land is.
Yes.
Because you cannot come and take somebody out because it's your ancestral. Take another option. You can resettle someone. It doesn't matter. On the grounds of where your parents have been met, you can always come periodically and see. I personally, just recently, maybe you must have heard in the radio, there was the group of my family. We have got a very big family here, maybe one out of 10 heroes, everyone is my family. So we met at Oji in Aparelo, where Kauras, Chiriangas, not Kauras, but Kaura, Chiriange, or the name that I'm having, grandparents are buried. We went there. The place was full like this. So the farm belongs to somebody else. But he said that, go and look where is the grave. I have not seen it here. They didn't know because they they didn't know how the black people are being buried. They thought it was just stones. But when we came, we know that this is the place. Because those marks, they think it's just stones which are there, but we know that this stone means something. This is where they are. And we came and tell him that we found the graves. And we want to make a monument to them. Say, go ahead. But I'm not going to say that leave the farm because of the grave of Chiriakin said. If I were to be resettled, I can go anywhere else because I'm still in America. But I don't want to be resettled because I bought a farm. I tried my best to go to the bank without money. And they said that I must give them some deposit. I said, where do I get it from? I'm just coming from abroad. And they gave me 100%, which I paid off now. Now what am I going to do there just because of the grave of my father? Isn't it me there? I'm already having a leg. So, in the place where I'm living, there is a grave of somebody whom I don't know there. Overlapping is a serious issue.
Yeah.
Therefore, governments, let us recognize it, but let us solve it in such a way that we are not really stepping on someone's foot. We have to. The time has come that we shall never forget about our ancestors. It will be there always. But we should not claim it at the expense of other people.